During all my film work, I carried a camera wherever I went and continued to take a lot of stills, as we call them. And had such good chances, like photographing Nehru and other heads of state, like Beneš, the Czech president who had his government here in London during the war, and others, of course Julian Huxley and Sean O'Casey. I photographed a lot and got very friendly with him and his family. And my photographs found appreciation, and in 1982 it was, I had my first big exhibition here in London at the Photographers Gallery, which was then run by Sue Davis, a wonderful woman who did a lot for photography in this country and is still active. I subsequently had other exhibitions. I published children's books, photographed in color in those days, which was rather early color. The most known one was called That Baby, about a young boy who expects a sibling, and it was made by with the help of a psychologist who worked with Anna Freud, and was found very useful by parents who wanted to introduce the problem to their young son or daughter. There were other children's books, alphabets, and later I did a book in 57, I believe, with Julian Huxley writing the text about animals, mammals mainly. It was called The Kingdom of the Beasts, published by Thames and Hudson, long out of print, unfortunately. In those days, it was very difficult to get photographic books published because it was a very expensive process. Photogravure was the best, but you had to have an edition about 20,000 to make it pay. I subsequently had exhibitions in Amsterdam and in Vienna, and a book published a couple of years ago in Vienna in two languages, which is still about.
But most of your photos have been black and white, haven't they?
Most of my all my photographs exhibited or published were in black and white, except the early children's books. And
because you prefer it.
I prefer it, and I never learned how to print color. I did all my own printing for exhibitions, and the pictures in my last book were all scanned from my prints.
Okay.